Welcome back, mga kaibigan. Good morning. So we are still under lecture 101. Our topic is how to conduct due diligence. Let us start. As a recap, we need to know again the definition of due diligence. Due diligence is the investigation or exercise of care that a buyer is normally expected to do before entering into a real estate sales agreement with the seller. Remember that conducting due diligence is a very important thing to do. Pabalik-balik ko pong kinasabi yan, huwag po tayo magpakatanga. We have to conduct due diligence before buying a real property in the Philippines. So we again enumerate, ulitin-ulit. Number one, know the proof of ownership. Number two, know how to verify a land title. Number three, know the seller. Number four, conduct ocular inspection. Number five, know the taxes and legal expenses. And number six, find a real notary public. Now, we finished already the proof of ownership. Now we are going to tackle how to verify a land title. Now, verification of land title. Well, we have to know whether it is fake or genuine. There are many posts on the internet on how to determine a fake land title, among which is the post of my colleague Joan Almaden in PhilPropertyExpert.com. Colleague in the real estate broker, as a real estate broker. Of course, when a supposed duplicate original owner's copy is presented to you by the seller, you must at least somehow be able to know if it is, at the very least, determine if it is fake or not. Kasi it is not made of an ordinary paper. It's a unique kind of paper. The title is a judicial form printed exclusively by the Banco Central ng Pilipinas. Sabi nga, 50% cotton daw siya at saka 50% chemical wood pulp. And the texture is similar to that of a bank check. Tapos, if you hold it up dun sa ilaw, you will see a watermark ng Land Registration Authority. So, these are the security features of the paper of the land title, no? But the truth is, we're not really an expert, no? We are not even in the business of knowing this. But it's not wrong to know this tips on how to determine whether it's fake or genuine in the internet, no? But many can still be fooled kasi marami pa rin ang maloko despite the fact na akala nila original o hindi. So, what is the best thing to do? The best thing to do is to proceed to the Land Registration Authority, Registry of Deeds, where the property is located, and present the original owner's copy of the land title. Now, take note if that the seller would not agree to bring the land title to the Registry of Deeds, then something is wrong. It rings a bell that you should not proceed with the sales transaction. Okay, let us assume na pumayag ang seller. Okay, we will present the owner's copy to the Registry of Deeds. And when checked by the Registry of Deeds, actually, remember that it is the government agency which is the expert to determine whether or not a land title is fake or not. So when the Registry of Deeds inspected it and said it's okay, it's genuine, it's not fake, bili ka kagad? Not yet. You have to secure a what we call a certified true copy of a title. Why? Bakit ka kailangan magkuha ng certified true copy of title? You would know if the title is clean or not. If it is a clean title or not. Kasi, possibly, merong mga annotations on adverse claim. Merong annotation on mortgage. Merong lease pendants o may pending case. Or may annotation on attachment or levy and execution. Merong homeowner's deed of restrictions, the one that we discussed already earlier in the first video. Or merong annotation on lease contract, which we have to respect. If you're the buyer and there is an existing lease contract, you have to respect the lease contract. Merong Rule 74 of the Rules of Court annotation. And others, which we all call this as problematic annotations. Now, I have here an example of an electronic certified true copy of the title. No, these are actually 3 pages. No, so I will disappear for a while. Now, these 3 pages that we see here, I got this from www.buholrealty.net. No, so credit to them. We will try to zoom in and look at this. If you notice that on the lower left portion, we have the reference number, date, time, official receipt number, official receipt date, and amount paid for securing the certified true copy of the title. And it states here that is page 1 of 3, and tinabi, an official copy, if not of blue color, dapat blue ang color, tapos meron siyang barcode. Similarly, dun sa second page, ganun din. Meron din nun. Tapos sinasabi dito, page 2 of 3. So kung pinakita sa inyo 2 pages lang ng certified true copy, ibig sabihin, kulang ng isa. Hanapin yung isa. Kasi ganun din sa third page, no? Still, the same features, the barcode, the reference number, etc., is reflected there. Now, going back to the first page, you will notice that it is already computer written. No? You see the title number, the technical description, the name of the owners, and on the second page, you will see the continuation of the technical description and even the size of the area, which is here, it is stated as 1,172 square meters. So, that is the second page. Now, the third page is here. The Memorandum of Encumbrance. Ayun, meron siyang annotation. Ito yung sinasabi nating annotation. Now, ibig sabihin lang ho dito is nalipat na ang titulo sa registered owner bilang mana sa kanya or through succession. Dapat kasi, lahat ng mga tagapagmana ay nakasali sa pag-angkin sa naiwan na propiedad para wala tayong deprived heir, or dapat yung pinagkautangan ng namatay ay nabayaran para wala tayong deprived creditor. Now, does it mean you should no longer buy the property? Well, this particular annotation will serve as a notice to you and to the whole world transacting on that property that there is a 2-year period where an omitted heir or a deprived creditor may possibly question your purchase. That is the simple meaning of the annotation I presented to you. Meaning, this kind of lien or annotation should make you extra careful and exert more due diligence to determine that there are no deprived heirs or deprived creditors. Sa ibang banda naman, yung other kinds of problematic annotations, it will likewise serve as a notice to you and to the whole world transacting on that property that there is a claim against the property by a party that is not the owner, such as in the case of an adverse claim, no? Or that it serves as a warning of some restrictions on the use of the property. You have to understand that said problematic annotations or encumbrance can have an impact on the transferability of the property and restrict its free use until that particular encumbrance is lifted. So I'm back. But doesn't mean that you will no longer proceed to purchase this property. Pwede pa rin siyang bilhin. You just, what I'm trying to say is that you just need to be extra careful. Of course, if you know for a fact that lahat ng heirs were present and they all signed the extrajudicial settlement, alam mo yun, then no problem with that. Alam mo namang walang deprived heir, then you proceed with the sale. Now, ito lang gusto kong i-add sa inyo. Pag mayroon kasi yung nakita na title na ganito, and makita rin nyo sa certified true copy of the title na may annotation on Rule 74 of Rules of Court, the first thing that you do is to determine if nag-lapse na yung 2-year period. Pag nag-lapse na yung 2-year period, the first requirement that you will tell the seller of the property, pakilift muna yung encumbrance na yan, pakitanggal muna. Paano po? Simple, just file a petition with the Registry of Deeds where the property is located and ask that it be lifted, because within the 2-year period, nobody complained, no creditor complained, and therefore it must be lifted because it already napaso na, pwede na siyang tanggalin. Then after that, you proceed with the transaction. Alright? So, right now, I will stop here, no? We will continue the discussion on this due diligence guide number 2. Next time, we will be discussing verification of documents, yung walang titulo, if there is no title, and ang proof of ownership niya, sabi niya, wala akong titulo but I have several documents to show my ownership. We will discuss that next time. So with that, as usual, I would say, muchas gracias, thank you, danke, sukran, and I will see you next time.